Hey everyone, it's Wednesday, December 4th, 2024, step 13 day. How are you guys feeling? Yesterday I said today is step 11, but then you know how the step system is not precisely with that solar calendar. So now like it's like skip step 12 and now step 13, but we'll definitely experience this step 12, which was very transformational. How are you guys feeling today? I had a good cry last night, and I think it's just like my own story was crumbling, and I'll tell you more in a minute, but I am like finding peace with all parts of myself. I'm very proud of myself for my transformation. But how are you guys feeling today? Feel free to type in the comment to welcome everybody. Welcome to my speaking meditation time. We're moving our energy and our perception and moving our fascia and through talking and affirmations and programming and unprogram some of that stories that we have so that we can reprogram new patterns and new patterns, new life, and that new story is here. So I would like to start with rubbing my hands. It's a good practice to tune into your body, scan your body before you start your day, because you know we interact with so many people throughout the day, whether it's in person or online. And if you don't know where you are in the morning, we will get confused, right? Like it's like, is this coming from me or is everybody, right? Or the astral energy, all of that. So the more you know where you stand, the more patient you become, because we become more patient and understanding of ourselves. Just going to go around my body. How's your mood? I'm just gonna do a little bit of quick circle. I'm moving my feet too. And to get into the energy of the day, today is a very much like step 13 is next to 4, which is Aquarius energy. It's an innovative day, and so transdimensional day, law of attraction in place, and it's an eccentric day. You know, anything could happen, break it to breakthrough. That's the energy 13. So let me just start reading it. So I'm an Seer Show. It's an astrology app. Really helps me move through my energy and finding inner peace within loving myself and loving myself more. So step 13, I believe in love evolution. So it's like a love evolution. Innovation and breakthrough discoveries rule the day. It's time to take the story you live every day to a higher level. This can only happen when you follow what your heart believes. So heart represent 1 and beliefs represent 3, net to 4. That's the energy of the day. So innovation and breakthrough. So in order for something to come, something needs to leave from ourselves, like whether that's a physical thing or energetic thing, and so that we can create space. And so whatever meant to break is meant to break today. But as you go through that, it's always that breakthrough. So don't be afraid. We're all learning to move forward with courage. That's another thing. Your ego is ready to love yourself on a whole other level. It's likely that today will be the day you determine this truth for yourself, and we'll begin a six-week journey starting tomorrow with Mars retrograding. Today is about discovery. Tomorrow, new beginnings. With Mercury retrograde conjoining the Sun this evening at 14, your mind will also come to clarity about how life needs to change and upgrade. Celebrate the new. So, a lot of things are moving. Time is definitely speeding up. But one thing I will say, I am getting better and better at accepting all parts of myself. And I'm not afraid of facing my shadow. For me, I did address that at yesterday's live. I do carry a lot of sadness, and but I'm coming to a inner peace, like coming to find my inner peace through this, which I am so excited about, and I'm happy with myself because I neglected this sadness for a very long time, and just like, oh, sadness, go away, and you know, like, why am I always sad, all of that. But it's just, you know, like I'm loving my sadness now. Or even when I'm not loving, I'm like fully trying to feel this. So when the sadness comes up and it's like, okay, here you are, my old friend. And I love you, sadness. I see you, I feel you, I accept you. And just let's feel it. Let's move this energy out. And there was a lot of power in that, I noticed. And instead of like neglecting it, instead of pushing it away, brushing it off, like you actually, you don't necessarily have to face, you know, because that's another, maybe creates a little resistance in you. So it's just like, hi, hello, sadness, hello, whatever that toxic trait that you have been ignoring. It's like, hello, I see you. Let's move through. What do you want me to see? Right? And it's just like move through it together. So I think that is super powerful. So now let's see what more to say. Today, net 4, I belong is a whirling state of awareness. In your fourth year of serious joy, you know by now that I belong energy is transdimensional. This is the conscious state of awareness that allows one to enter into an entirely new dimension that is possible. So quantum shift happened today, and that's possible. That dimension in which you enter is determined by where your heart feels you belong. This is because in creation, every dimension is created by the heart's desires. I love that. So the dimension in which you enter is determined by where your heart feels you belong. Where you belong, that's where you stay. This is because in creation, every dimension is created by the heart desires. I love that. Every dimension. So there's multiple timelines and all of that, dimensions and all of that is created by the heart desires. Today, you will be shifting the dimension of what you believe in life. That is powerful. What you believe is what you become. What you believe is what you become. In the spectrum of knowledge, dimensions are known as perspectives. Interesting. Dimensions are known as perspective, and there are millions of perspectives, right? Therefore, today you are going to shift your perspective on your daily life by choosing the belief your heart is most attracted to. So there are so many possibilities, timelines, perspective. When you look at one thing, you can see from here, you can see from there, 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 there. And choose that one that most you're most attracted to. And that's where your power is, right? It doesn't matter where you've been, all, you know, mistakes you've made, or how sick you've been, or, you know, finance, it doesn't matter. You get to choose today, but do you feel worthy to choose the timeline? Do you feel worthy to choose that perspective? Can you gift yourself that timeline? So let's think about that. This is knowledge through the law of attraction. A person is attracted to a belief or an idea because they want to experience that perspective on earth. Oh yeah, that's very true. We're constantly making choices because you want to experience that. Today, you may find yourself drawn to a different perspective in life than you have taken before. You may realize that your heart has taken the wrong perspective on a situation, relationship, or event. Wrong perspective means that your heart did not agree with the angle. So, you know, you can't really make mistakes in anything, because it's like every perspective can lead to another one. And here comes the trust and the faith, right? When you set the intention, you just trust that it will happen. But along the way, you're taking different choices in every moment. But and it goes like this, but trust that you will get there. But the very things that you wanted to get there could, you know, maybe like core does not change, but the very, you know, little details like, oh, I wanted to attract this specific thing might change, right? As you shift, that maybe the things that you wanted could change. And yeah, but in order for us to choose the right perspective, even though there's no right or wrong, you have to connect with your heart, because wrong perspective, that's if there's anything like that, means that your heart did not agree with the angle. So as long as you keep choosing your heart desire every moment, here comes the arts, right? Arts of practicing, listening to your heart, because there are a lot of voices. Voices from our mind, brain, ego, heart. Are you listening? So it has been one, your mind, ego, or emotion pushed for inside of you, but your heart knows better. Yeah, it has been one. Okay, wrong perspective means that your heart did not agree with the angle. It has been one, your mind, ego, or emotions pushed for inside of you, but your heart knows better. Your heart, you know, like it's like I literally have this image of putting my heart on a pedestal. It's like, I honor you, I love you, and you're the queen, right? And your mind and ego has to go like that. And when I say I am worthy of receiving the best version of my ego, my mind, and that honors this heart desire instead of my ego and my mind and try to always, you know, overpower the heart. But it's like, know your place. Your place, you're the servant of the heart, right? So in my mind, like going like, they were going like this, the heart is on the pedestal. And I think it's a practice to keep reminding your mind and ego that it's like, you are literally the servant of your heart, of my heart. And you listen and do what your heart says, do what my heart says, right? So that's the art that you practice, because it was a programming, right? We are programmed to listen to our mind and ego, and then they thought that they were the boss, but that was not the case. It's like, no, we're not doing this anymore. You listen to your heart, and that's the truth. That's your only job. Okay, your heart's truth will reveal today a greater perspective to look at your life. It's a greater perspective because the idea brings you happiness and joy. So when something brings you happiness and joy, that's the answer. Can we follow that joy? Happiness comes from your heart feeling a strong relationship to the idea or a strong attraction to the idea. The heart identifying means you belong, taking that perspective. In each of your stories today, identify what your heart believes is true in the situation. Determine the perspective you belong taking if what your heart believes is true. It doesn't matter. Here comes the paradox. You know, you will interact with someone, and then when people say something and try to influence their perspective onto us, and you know, maybe it's a good influence, but always remember, we have a choice, we have free will. You know, even though someone else doesn't believe in the perspective, it's like, no, this is what I believe, and this needs to happen, and I create my own reality, you do you, I do me, and we can still be in the same field, and you're welcome. But I have my strong boundaries about what I believe, and in this strong boundaries in my energy field, this is the truth. You get to claim that, right? Yeah, I love that thought. Yes. And as I'm talking, I'm enforcing my boundaries so that I can literally reminding myself, this is how I live my life, and this is how I lead my life with my heart, so that I get better and better and better at it. So yes. So heart desire, the voice that comes from our heart, that's our intuition, that's our truth, can be very soft and subtle. Can we catch that? And also another key to listen to the heart desire is, does this idea bring me joy and bringing joy and happiness, right? That's the truth. And if that idea brings you sadness, maybe look into that, look it with them. Maybe you need to dance a little, then dance with your sadness a little. Let's move with me. Let's move with me. This is not true for me anymore. And just see that part of yourself. I see you, acknowledge you. I do that with my tension in my body too. It's like there's a tightness and there's a stuff that I'm working through. And it's been a while, as much as I can get, okay, no more. I don't want this. But it's like, it's in there, right? So I think it's all about that, you know, let's move through this, the willingness to move forward with courage. It doesn't matter what you've been and what your body, how your body has been, or how your financial situation has been. It doesn't matter. Like, you know, just empower yourself. Move your body. Let's move with me, right? That's what I said to my body this morning. It's like, let's move with me. I see you. There's a heavy part of myself in my body. I feel it like right here in my hips. It's like, okay, let's move with me. Let's move. Move with me. There's nothing wrong with you. You are safe to exist. You are safe in this world, because that feeling, fear of, you know, not feeling safe, that got me where I am. And that got my body where it is, right? So the sense of safety creates the relief, let go. And when we let go, we become magnetic, the energy exchange. And when I feel safe enough, when my body feels safe enough, it let go. And then my heart will feel safe, because, you know, we're safe. We have better boundaries. We can catch ourselves when something try to trigger and challenge me. It's like, no, we're not doing this. Now, when our heart feels safe, our heart opens and I feel more joy. Okay, I like this idea. Let's follow. Lead with the heart. And when we lead with the heart, it brings us more joy, more happiness, and follow that bliss. And then when you follow that bliss, and you start to attract good things that are good for us, then we feel worthy, we feel more valuable, and we feel enough. Or we gotta start with that idea. We are valuable, we are worthy, it's our birthright. We get to demand this birthright, right? So when you establish that core belief about yourself from the very core, it's our foundation. Like, we're blessed, we get to create, when we get to demand this, like, please, please, you know, I give myself full permission to receive. And from that point, you become more magnetic and you attract, and you're worthy of receiving the best version of everything. So that's what I'm working on. That's what we'd love for you to work on, because we're all deserving of love. We are all worthy of love. We are all worthy of abundance. We are all worthy of all the amazing, beautiful things in life. And we're all worthy. Can you feel that when you hear? We are so worthy of receiving all the love, all the abundance, and all the freedom. And the freedom to do whatever we want without ever worrying about how much money we have. That's the type of energy I'm going for, while having fun, right? Because it's like, it's nothing makes sense if you're doing things and not having fun. That's the worst. So, okay. You may be challenged today to grow from a conversation, intellectual challenge, or something breaking down in your plans. Don't respond to your normal way. Remember what you believe and respond according to that. A long-term creative project, romantic affair, or a personal dream may hit an obstacle or fall apart today. Rework your approach with a solution you both love and believe is possible. Today's goal is to follow exactly what your heart believes and see where it takes your overall perspective on life. So sometimes when things are breaking down, it's kind of like, okay, where's my faith, right? Do I have faith in this? But I think it's faith is something that you decide when maybe even when nothing seemed to be working or nothing seemed to be moving or breaking down and moving but breaking down, then it's like, no, I am worthy, I am lovable, and I am enough, and I am deserving of receiving all the abundance, and this is what I trust. Even when the old story is crumbling, even the very little things that you wanted seems crumbling, but it's know that, okay, good things come out of this, good things come out of this, good things come out of this. Maybe say that 3 times. I heard about the rules, I forgot. I think it's when you think of negative thought, you have to override and erase and replace with 5 times, you know, positive thought. I think the rule, I forgot, 1 versus 5 or something like that. So when you have 1 negative thought, you have to think of 5 positive things to override it, right? If a thought slash action makes you upset, but it might be the right practical thing to do to keep your loved one safe, better life, sometimes we need to decide what's right in this paradox. Oh yes, 5 is correct. Thank you, pure breathwork. I mean, you know, like it's all about what you think, but yeah, 1 to 5, I don't know how they exactly say that, 1 to 5 rules, something. When you think of like 1 negative thoughts and you overwrite with 5 positive thoughts, or maybe you say 1 positive thing 5 times. And I think that's a good thing. And I think I've seen this, like I think Abraham also talks about it, but there was maybe research from Japan, my country. Like you think of something for 7 seconds. Am I right, pure breathwork? When you think of things for, hold that thought for 7 seconds, and then that will start to materialize. That's how energy works, you know? 17. Thank you. Okay, you gotta hold it a little longer, not 7 seconds. So I think Abraham Hicks talks about, and then there's another one more timeline, right? When you hold the thoughts for 17 seconds and you start to materialize, and then when you really hold that thought for another more, I forgot, is that 90 seconds? And then you can really reaffirm that thought. So so it's a programming after all, right? And Prony, going back to what you said, yeah, so is when you take that right action, the right action changes in you know, moment by moment, because I think our parents, my parents at least, did their best and did things that they thought the best, right? But maybe that best was not best. But I think it helps me to think, if it helps me when I think this way, every action I take, there is no right or wrong, but it becomes right when I take that action with my heart. And it seems very hard sometimes. It's like my heart says this and my brain says this. But I think we're going into this era. That's why I say it doesn't matter where you've been and how you've been and how you've making your own decisions. I think we just literally shifted to a timeline. You can allow yourself and you're gonna be okay, taking action and making decisions with the heart. Even though the brain said, this is probably the right thing to do, but I'm gonna choose and lead with my heart. And this is the power, but this is the hardest thing if you haven't practiced. And I think allow yourself, sit down with your heart, feel your body. And this is the art, right? You may not get it right away, but I think we're slowly coming to a point that we cannot control the outcome. We cannot control the outside circumstances. The only thing we can control is literally our reaction to things. And learn to be better and better at surrendering, trusting, letting go. And let go and let it come. Let it go, let it flow. Let it go, let it flow. Let it go, let it flow. I say that all the time. It's like, okay, finance. Because it's like our brain is just wants to, you know, entertain ourselves with the different narratives and the old stories and all of that. It's like literally tell them to shut up. Shut up. And shut up. Shut up, brain. We're doing this. Shut up, brain. We're doing this. We'll just put our heart, you know, imagine this little heart on a pedestal, on a throne, and then we honor them. And then we walk, we move forward life with courage, putting the heart. Because I think, you know, I think I'll be better and I feel better even when I make a mistake, leading with my heart. And it's okay. This is where trust comes from. When we came into earth, it's our birthright to be provided. It's our birthright to be lovable. It's our birthright to be safe. And so these three things are like fundamental. And I, for me, just knowing my astrology is huge for me. It's huge for me. Just to feel safe, and I get to demand that to create the sense of safety. It's my birthright. I'm just gonna, like, you know, I get to feel this safety, and I get to be lovable, and it's okay, you know, like I have this perfectionist side of me, meticulous, like I want to be this and that, and then to make that happen I need to do this, do that. No, it's like I am grateful. And I get to be lovable. Even when I mistakes, I'm still, when I, even when I make mistakes, I'm still lovable. That's a huge part. Because I've been a perfectionist. I became a perfectionist because I thought that when I'm perfect, I'll be loved. That's another layer. But I'm also, in nature, I'm very committed. I'm very detail-oriented. Can be very tiring. But I'm learning to use that as my advantage. Not to put myself down, but I'm not using it in a way that is detrimental for my mental health. Right? It's okay if it's not perfect. And sense of safety and the sense of love that we like, because I think my body has forgotten what it's like to completely feel safe to exist in the world. And that is like huge for me, because what it's like, I keep telling myself, like, please show me what it's like to feel completely safe to exist in the world. So I'm not like in the fight or flight mode anymore. My nervous system is literally calmed down. You know, like inflammation is that roots of every disease, and stress is one of it. Stressor is one of it. But inflammation, right? So. But when my nervous system is completely calmed down, nothing can harm me, literally, right? That's the truth. Nothing can harm me. It's like, if you know how powerful you are, how safe you are, it's your birthright coming into this earth. You're just here to create life and have fun. Can you embody? Can you literally feel that? I feel so worthy. I am so worthy. Just like when you use that word, you just feel it out, like from the core of your heart. It's like, I am lovable. I feel safe. I am safe. And I am worthy. Because when you feel those three things, safety, being loved, and being provided, and being worthy of receiving all of that you want, you know, even when your mind can say something else, right? Like, I like that. I want a shirt saying, shut up, brain. I noticed that, you know, do you guys have Canva? Canva is an app that you can create your posters and all kinds of banners and all kinds of cool stuff, cool videos even. But you can even make a shirt, and it's not that expensive. I look it up. Like, even when you just make like one order, because normally when you go to the t-shirts company, then you have to make a bulk order, right? Mass order. unless you want to, you know, start making the t-shirts and sell it to people, that would be fun. I thought about it actually, but then it's like, here comes, like, I gotta make a good shirt. But Shut Up Brain is a funny one for sure. Yeah, I like wearing, I found this on Amazon. It says spread kindness, and yeah, I have found the other one on Amazon that said, like, it's faith, and I like that word faith, but it looks like you know, the cross, and I'm not really Christian, and I, you know, I go up to school to teach dance, and I can't wear those things. I mean, I could, people have like necklace and all that, you know, but a cross, so it's, yeah, I mean, you know, like, it's, there's part of me that is like, I live my life and I live my truth, but also, you know, when I work for someone else and that goes with a different agenda, I mean, you know, we get to choose all that, but I've been told I go to school to teach dance, and there was a one happy song, it's like happy tone, there was nothing religious about it, and it was a K-pop song, and I know a lot of Koreans are Christian, but it's like, I think it's like, you know, some people are so meticulous, even the words are super powerful, but the usage of like, oh my God, for example. And this Korean song, the K-pop song, had this in the chorus, oh my God, dun 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 dun. And there was nothing religious about it. And but I, when my boss found out that I used that happy song, it was a love song. She was not very happy about the fact that the song had the God, the word God in it. So in school system, when I go up to teach dance, I'm not allowed to use the word God, deity, I don't know, anything to do with it. And so I tried to avoid that, right? But it's a very interesting time. But I think what I believe is, you know, people get to choose whatever they want to choose, right? And I think there's a beauty in the freedom. And but you don't really have to force people or, you know, force people to do this or that. I think it's, we're going to this world where we get to choose our own truth. And that's the truth that I'm choosing with my heart. So... okay, so just to finish, okay, today's goal is to follow exactly what your heart believes and see where it takes your overall perspective on life. It's also possible that you know exactly what your heart believes and you're waiting to find your like-minded believers. If this is the case, you will be learning where you belong in society instead of what you belong believing. Stay true to what you believe and you will find your tribe. Enjoy the experience. I belong believing in life. Yes. So what you believe is what you become. What you believe is what you become. I sometimes feel like it's like start rapping, saying things. I love myself, I love myself, I love myself. And I just like go with the rhythm, right? I believe in myself, I believe in myself. Because all the rap originated from the church, right? Chanting. And the chanting becomes a rap, right? And then when you exactly go into the history of hip hop, and the rap is the one of the elements of hip hop, and then just rap, it's come from the chanting in the Christian church, right? So that's very powerful. Words are powerful. Anyways, I picked two cards today, and one is believing yourself, unleash your inner unicorn. It's time to make some sparkle magic and unleash your inner unicorn. The enchanting unicorn embodies the feminine yin energy of the moon and represents magic, mystery, intuition, innocence, courage, wisdom, fulfillment, and abundance. It connects us with our truest essence by teaching us to trust our own intuition and believe in our unique sparkle magic. Our inner unicorn knows our wildest dreams and desires. Tapping into that untamed energy feels like absolute freedom and gives you permission to be your authentic self. This card shows up when you've been doubting yourself and hiding your unique sparkle magic? Where have you been holding yourself back? Be honest. The horn sits on top of the crown chakra, divine consciousness, and holds magic healing power to help banish beliefs that limit you from letting your light shine. Yes. And another card, so the two card picks. Celebrate yourself, you deserve it. Yay, you're amazing, so take a moment to celebrate yourself. It's almost become normal to punish ourselves while we're in pursuit of our goals with negative thoughts like I'm not there yet or it's not perfect. Yeah, that's my tendency, but I am being better at being kind to myself. We need to flip the script on those self-defeating thoughts and learn to celebrate the small stuff. If you pull this card, it is time to celebrate how far you've come in this exact moment. You're doing an awesome job at life, even if you don't feel like it. Stop waiting for the major monthly holidays and learn to celebrate yourself daily. The more you praise and celebrate your life, the more there is in life to celebrate. When was the last time you celebrate yourself? Been a while? Do something today that honors you and all your amazingness. Celebrating yourself doesn't always have to be extravagant. You can keep it simple and dress up, buy some flowers, write yourself a love note, take a nap, or treat yourself to a fancy dinner. You deserve it. I celebrate myself today and every day because I deserve it. So the key for today is to, as usual, in the Sagittarius season, it's all about belief, upgrading our belief system. I will say this every single day, what you believe is what you become. And can you believe that you are so deserving, and you're deserving to celebrate yourself every single day. It's the work, right? Yesterday, I had this, I had a little bit of break it to breakthrough moment. I had this sadness came up, and I compare my life with other people's life. Do you do that? And then it's like, wow, I just like pause for a moment and notice where I am. Sometimes there's a moment that you reflect upon yourself and your life, and it's like it's just seeing like where I am, and sometimes seeing where I am makes me so grateful. Sometimes seeing where I am makes me so sad. And it's about the perspective, how I see things, right? And then when I see the perspective that makes me sad, of course, coming from that, expectations and inner childhood wounds and programming that I have, and it's just so different, compared to, I live in Canada, but I grew up in Japan, it's so different from how the average Japanese people like me, like my class, people who I grew up with that I don't talk, but they were so different. And okay, the siren is reminding me. It's like, no, alarm. But I think, and also compare myself with the average Canadian people. Like, I mean, there's so many different type of people, but I think I'm mostly talking about people who are married and have kids and all of that. But it's like, and I stopped myself, and I just going to fully accept the fact that I am different, and I chose a bit of, because I'm different, I had to choose a different life, and here I am, and accept it. Here I am. It's okay. I'm different. I was never meant to fit in, and I spent a lot of time trying to fit in and thinking how different I am, and just digging into why I'm so different, and that's a different rabbit hole. Right? I think we're meant to be different, and just accepting that, the fact that I'm different. So, lots of emotion came up. So let's finish with the heart and the brain. And I know that this is just part of that process, right? Break it to breakthrough. And It's okay to release that energy. Everyone has different perspectives. Despite infinite perspectives, is the truth only one? Can there more than one truth? I think truth is where your heart says yes. And when you feel that perspective, when your heart says yes, 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 or when your heart says yes, right? It's like the nuance, you know, maybe like yes, or no, right? So I don't think the truth is just the one, and it changes in this, you know, duality world. But the truth itself, the core, is probably does not change and unshakable. Probably like, you know, the core belief that we've been cultivating, like we are loved. Like, do you believe that we're unlovable, you know? And those like obvious thing, right? That the truth. But, you know, maybe little things about something, someone, like that will probably change depending on the perspective. Yeah. So I think it's leading with your heart. It's important. And learning to listen to your heart. And when you get confused, is that voice coming from my heart or, you know, feelings? Or because it's like the feelings are the mixture of your heart desire and then maybe something else too, right? So you got to really differentiate the voices. And this is the art. This is the training. And hi, Nancy. That makes you, you create. Yeah, it's, you know, accepting how different I am. Difference should be celebrated. Yeah, so I am accepting. Sometimes it's like, you know, you carry your life and then you just like don't think about it. When you stop yourself, it's like thinking about how different you are. And then that's maybe part of me. I'm happy with it. I'm different. But part of me, and it's like, why I'm so different? It's the same, almost like a same identity crisis that people might go through. Like if you're like, you know, trans person and transitioning, that's the identity crisis, right? That needs to happen. It's like, I'm different. I'm going to be this. And I think that, you know, process can be very different, but the idea can be very similar. You know, like it's just like, just accepting that you don't feeling the society, just accepting the fact that you are different and you're okay with it and you learn to celebrate that regardless. And in the age of Aquarius, it's all about that. It's like no one's asking you to be the same. We all get to be different and we are different. We talk about society and fitting in, but everyone is so different, right? But some are more eccentric than the other in one aspect or many aspects. And I think being honest with yourself and authenticity, being authentic and be honest with yourself. And that's what leads to your heart, right? What does your heart want? And maybe we can't see how. And we're not meant to see how. How comes from the higher realm, different timeline probably, right? In order to switch to the higher timeline, we just need to shift the perspective, how you see things. And if you cannot see the different, the solution, the answer in a different perspective, then you have to just dig deeper and allow yourself full permission to see more different perspective, and we get to choose and we get to see in the infinite perspectives about things and choose. And let's choose the most expansive, joyful perspective. It doesn't necessarily have to be the most highest, because if you're not having fun, what's the point, right? Even though that's how my brain thinks, you know? Okay, highest timeline. But it's like, what if the highest timeline is so boring, right? So let's choose a timeline that is most expansive, joyful. And it's not about, you know, having fun because you have all these activities or surrounded by all these amazing people. It's not necessarily about that. It's a state of mind, state of your health, and what is happiness depends on the people, but for me, I am slowly finding inner peace within. It's not about what I have, it's not about where I am, it's about choosing myself every moment, choosing my heart every moment. That's probably that happiness. Makes me emotional. Being silly is joyful too. Yeah, being silly is joyful, exactly. So I love that. I never actually thought about that until I said it. Happiness is choosing myself every moment. Interesting. I'll dig deeper into that. Right hand on your heart, left hand on top of your head, just to finish off with the heart and the brain. Imagine the heart, energy go through our heart and our brain, and then let's feel your heartbeat, feel your body. Breathe your mouth. Two. Three. Through your nose. Two. Three. Hello heart. Sorry. Hello brain. Hello ego. Hello brain. Hello mind. I don't need your protection anymore because I am safe in my body. And I feel safe to exist in the world. I am safe to exist in the world. Now please listen and do what my heart says. So this is me saying, shut up brain. Right, Promni? So now, hello heart, you're in charge. I put you on a pedestal. I honor you. And I love you. I follow you. I listen to you. You're the boss. I love myself. I am loved. I am lovable. I am safe. I am protected. I am provided. I am enough. I don't need to be perfect. I live with love. Every decision I make, every breath I take, I am worthy. I'm worthy of receiving all the abundance that life has to offer. I'm so worthy of receiving the best version of everything. My health, my body, my relationship, my finance, my home environment, everyone that I work with. I deserve the best of best because I know how I am worthy. I am so worthy. I feel it in my whole body. I am worthy. I am lovable. I am valuable. What I offer, who I am, is helpful to the world. I value myself. Anyone, you can add anything you want. I'm joyful. I am choosing myself. I love myself. All is well. Good things. Only good things come my way. Only good things come my way. Everything is working out for me in my favor. Everything is working out for me in my favor. Feel your body. Let's do another six breath. Breathe your mouth. Two, three, your nose, two, three. Feel your body. Yes, those affirmations are so powerful. I want to write them down. Your heart, brain, coherence. Can you say love, please? Yes, I actually do this every day at the live in the end to finish. But basically, you get to choose anything you want, right? Super powerful. You talk to connect with your heart and the brain. And for me, I notice I want to add brain, mind, and ego. you know, and I, because I am working on that, you know, cultivating a sense of worthiness, one day I realized that if I'm worthy, then I deserve the best version of my ego. You know what I mean? Best version of my mind. You know, I deserve it. I don't want any version of my mind, my ego, constantly try to overpower my heart. What are you doing, right? So I said to myself one day, I am deserving. I am so worthy of receiving the best version of my ego. Give it to me. Give me the best version. Give me the best version of my mind. That honor the heart's desire, listen to the heart, not conflicting, right? And then talks to heart. It's like literally, you know, the heart, like an imagery of put the heart on the pedestal. Like, I honor you. You're the most you're the most valuable thing in the whole world. And because I am honor you and follow you, I know that I believe in this. And I believe in that safety, you know, like I am safe, I am lovable, and I am so worthy. I always like to add, so worthy, I am so worthy, I am so enough. Yeah, those specific ones are. And then we keep adding it on because we all have limited belief about things, right? What is it like for you to feel worthy? What is like to you to feel safe? Hi, Larry. Feel safe, so worthy, so safe, and so abundant, right? It's all about that idea. Then you take it to your heart, and your heart agrees, and your body needs to feel it out, right? Your body, so this is like mind, body, spirit stuff. So that is why I call it embody, because I really, really want to embody it, and I'm getting better at it, you know, embody and reprogramming and just reprogram and practice so much that train your brain so much that it's like you catch yourself when you catch a different idea. It's like, take it. Okay, I feel you, I see you, this is my old story, you can now leave, right? You can even get to do that. You get to make a choice. Even like when something, your old story comes up, and it's like, okay, I see you. Thank you for this reminder to reinforce my core boundaries. Thank you for this reminder. I now remind myself that I have new boundaries for myself. In my field, in my energy field, this would never happen because I feel worthy. I am valuable. I demand this in my energy field. Everyone gets to have their own timeline and create their own reality. Do whatever you want, you do you. But in my energy field, this is my truth, this is how I live my life, because I realize it's my birthright. It's my birthright coming into earth, right? To be lovable, to feel safe, to be safe and be abundant, and to be free, and to do whatever we want, and to get to be free, right? All of that. But we gotta do this every day, also with the words, also feel it out and put that into our subconscious, which is also connected to our fascia. Yes, thank you so much, Kaya Mac. Thank you for joining. So and that is the essence of every live that I do every morning, because it helps me program my fascia, go into my subconscious, and just really completely reprogram ourselves, how worthy we are, how loved, how safe we are. And we get to celebrate ourselves. Don't ever feel bad about spending money on something that brings you joy, right? Don't ever feel bad about spending an investment into your health, right? Your health is an investment, not your expense, right? Like all of that. If you feel so worthy that you get to give this talk to yourself. Like, this is something that I do. Like talking to myself, voice it, just like my, you know, just like my best friend or that my partner. It's like, what do you want to eat? Like, do you want to do this? Do you want to do that? I'm still learning, but, you know, getting better at it, getting better at dancing and moving with my sadness and dancing and moving with my fear and my anger, all of that. But every time I dance with my shadow, I reinforce my core belief. I am lovable. I am safe. I am worthy. So I think every word, each word hits differently, right? For me, those three things, it got me where I need to be right away. So think about the words that help you elevate, right? And really ingraining in that idea into your DNA, subconscious. Yes, learning so much. Thank you so much for your comment. Missed you last 2 days. Hi, Lee. Working a lot. That's great. I'll pause the recording. I just bought me 3 pairs of dancing shoes. That's awesome. Black Friday. Dancing makes me happy, right? So I am excited. What to come. Thank you guys for joining. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. But please, please, let's work on a sense of safety. Sense of love, how lovable you are, and sense of worthiness. I think those are that, like, the three things that only need to work on, because if you know that, right, I think everything falls into place. Whatever's happening, you just know. We don't need to tighten up your body. Your calm nervous system is calm because you know you're safe. You're not gonna die, or let's say, you know, whatever, right? There's nothing to fear. And even though you're going through something, you just know that you're lovable, then you don't have to try so hard to try to do something to be lovable, you know what I mean? You already know you're lovable. And last thing, if you know so worthy that even when you are in that hard financial situation, just demand the universe, reprogram and remind yourself how worthy you are. And if you know worthy of receiving, what it's like for you to receive everything that you want instead of your mind and your ego trying to get in the way. Shut up, brain. I'm worthy. Oh, I like that. Shut up, brain. I'm worthy. Also, another one that I came up with today, choosing yourself choosing yourself is happiness. So thank you guys. I'll see you tomorrow. I love you and sending you guys so much love, and love is the answer. Bye.